Hi, for today's teardown, this one more total station. I have already a teardown of a Pentax total station. This one is the Topcon brand, like my pipe laser teardown. Model GTS 300, and it is actually still quite a valuable item when in working condition. I got this one from Germany on eBay for 30 euros, mainly because it is broken, working strangely, not always responsive. The main problem being this big impact here and pretty bad fungus infestation in the lens I will show you later. So it comes complete this time with the battery handle and with the mounting plate, which is good. My other total station had no mounting plate, no battery, but the transit case. So we will first have a look around. So like the other total station, we have one control panel on each side. We have here an additional control panel with the main functions on the side. Main eyepiece with laser telemeter. Optical plummet here. This viewfinder will actually go straight in the middle, downwards to check the plummet. And it is almost a little auxiliary view finder here, target finder, something like this. This one is powering on at least and giving some signs of life, even if it seems more or less broken. So I will zoom on it for you first. So here you have the control panel, a little bubble level here. So if I power it on, because the battery is not completely dead, you will see that the rotary encoder on this axis at least is working and is measuring quite precisely the position. But on the other axis, it is acting weird. Sometimes it will start to work, sometimes not. Look at this, it is sometimes working. So I wonder if a wire is broken somewhere or something like this. And the controls are not always responsive. Sometimes they work, sometimes not. There is a backlight, green backlight on this LCD, but very, very faint. And it will actually also do a green backlight in the reticle, but I'm not sure you will be able to see. Ah, yes, you can see here the green LED. You see this green dot? Here, it is the reticle by, backlight, which will light the eyepiece in here. The green, red LED, by the way, you can see, is from my camera. It is not from the device, and it is not the laser output of the device. So what else? Here is the main control panel. Quite obscure functions of these keys for me. Record, obviously. Units conversion. There is a data logging system provided, main power switch. Here you have this thing, the setting and locking buttons here. On the top, the battery with release button, screw to secure it at the other side, fuse and power input. I did budge something, I was able to recharge a little bit this battery. So it is working for now. Here on the stand or tri-brack adapter, it's called this, there is another bubble level with a center bubble, which is actually pretty tedious to adjust. You can play with it quite some time before you find the correct spot. Here we are. So nice piece here. Here another power input and data logger plug apparently. Okay. And now you can see for some reason it did stop to measure. I do not know why. So it is really acting weird, this thing. It is why it was so cheap. And here for you playing at home, the actual model and serial number. Of course, all Japan made. Okay, so it is the walk around of this thing. Now I will separate the parts for you. Power off. Ah, before. One thing I need to show you, I will try to show you, is the actual fungus infestation in this lens. I am not sure of how it will show on camera. So if I shine a light, yes, you can see. Here, here. Fungus, pretty bad actually. On the top also. Here you can see it. So this is really a common issue with old optics. It happens more commonly in tropical countries to have this problem. But even here it did happen in something that was used in Germany, apparently. Maybe it was stored in a white room, garage or something like this. And it is what happens, and it is pretty difficult to clean the lens because obviously you need to take apart the optics and find a way to clean them. Look at this big one here. There is even a big part in the middle of I can see it is spraying and all around like a blob. Look at this here. Wow. So for this reason, and for, where is it again, this reason of a pretty bad impact here, I believe I might scrap this unit. I will maybe not keep it. I did not decide yet. So, let's remove the battery. It is just a matter of unscrewing here and releasing two contacts here. And two contacts here on the top. You can see my other total station had a permanently installed handle, not this one. The battery is actually the handle. And to remove the bottom adapter plate, it is just a matter of unlocking here. There is a provision here for screwing and securing a little bit more and lifting. Here we are, and here is, oops, excuse me, the bottom view of the thing with the eyepiece for the optical plummet. If I shine my light, where is it? Ah, it is actually what did fall here. Ah, of course, you should see the light shining here. Yes, so it is just a right angle viewfinder that will look downwards to center the tripod correctly and check if you are vertical, but I believe we have an horizontality level sensor inside here. Okay, now I will put the camera overhead and we will start to take it apart. We will start with having a look at this mounting plate, which actually has its own serial number and is quite valuable. So definitively, either I will keep it for using with a possible other total station, or I will maybe try to sell it and refund my total purchase, because it is in a very good overall condition, this thing, no problem whatsoever. You can see the free adjustment screws here with a very fine thread. The big screw hole here for the tripod. The bubble level with apparently a provision for fine adjustment in factory with this nuts, special nuts with side holes. And everything in either die-cast aluminium and here maybe a steel base plate. Made in Japan, of course, so super nice unit here. Ah, I did just see here a little bit of damage, sadly. Maybe it was caused by the same impact that did damage the main unit. But still perfectly possible to use. Okay, a look at the battery. So I will open one side for you because they are both the same inside, in fact. Old school nickel cadmium battery, but luckily enough, still in more or less working condition, or at least not completely dead. Here is the specifications, quite usual stuff, 7.2 volts. Model number here. Just the battery in a good working condition is probably worth something because they are quite hard to find, and it is here one more time die-cast aluminium, a little bit of aluminium oxidation here by the way. Very proprietary charge connector here. And inside, as expected, apparently we have some copper coating on this cover. Regular nickel cadmium elements, well wrapped and formed and everything. Some wires to interconnect everything. So we have two on this side, two apparently in the handle part, and two on the other side. And it is quite interesting, they are still in working condition because usually these batteries are always, always dead on all equipment. Okay, so we'll put this back together and we start to take apart the main unit. So this main unit, where to start? We will start by having a look at the what we have here under this bottom cover. So you can see we have a nice rotary part here, completely free. So for sure we have rotary contacts. So let's undo this bottom cover. I do not think we will find a lot behind it, but so it is interesting to note on this device, these screws are slotted screws, old school chrome finish slotted screws, like on all cameras. It must be from the 90s, I believe, this unit. We will maybe find a dead code later on. So, ah, here we are. I was saying rotary contacts. So here we have apparently four wires for the power supply and data. Here, probably serial data. So two data and two power supply. And you can see rotary contacts, and in the middle the optical piece. So the wires are actually along the optical path, but you cannot see them when you look in the eyepiece, which is here. Okay, you can see nice condition overall on this part. No problem whatsoever, but no golden contacts here, maybe there. But still very shiny, so probably some fancy metal anyways in here, maybe platinum or palladium, not sure. More here we have the Phillips screws, so maybe they did use Phillips screws for the hidden ones and slotted for the external ones, just for the look, overall look. So I will reinstall Discover and we will open this. By the way, behind this cover, nothing interesting, just the two plugs, a piece of circuit board and the wires connected to it, so nothing to see. So like on the other Total Station, you have two settings here for slow turning and locking of axis. We will probably find very similar things behind each one of these control panels, but I will take them both off anyways. So what do we have here? Just, yes, you can see the locking mechanism here. So it is very similar to what we have on the other one. So you can see the fine adjustment here. And brake mechanism with a spring loaded part here you can adjust with this screw piece. Back side of the control panel, two hockey shapes probably for the LCD. Bonded up tracks this thing and maybe we have a first dead code here of 92. Not too sure, we will try to find out. What do we see else in here? You can see the diecast construction of the body. And probably here the glass disc of the main rotary encoder for this vertical axis. With here probably the sensors going to it. It should be possible to undo this control panel completely, but I do not see the point of doing it at this time. And of course, Allen set screws in here. At least it is all the surface mount, so the first indication of the manufacturing date. Old school surface mount parts, so yes, most probably 90s. So I will reinstall this panel and we will check if we have the same thing behind the other one. So, suspense. Okay, really the same PCB here. The wire harness is blue, not white. And here, a better view at the rotary encoder, you can see. The wall glass piece, it seems it is actually enclosed in a clear cover here or something. Here I can see at the back probably the sensors to read it. Some flat circuit, flat cables going on, some cable retainers. And really, we do not see a lot in here, except here the assembly of a bubble level, which is possible to undo, apparently. But nothing in particular, apart this clear part, which is not really easy to access. We will have a better look, I believe, from this side after removing the side cover. But fancy stuff for sure. It is why these things are so expensive. Okay. So next I will undo this side cover. But first, here I did not tie around the eyepiece. So you have one more locking mechanism here and one eye focus adjustment here. But this cover will come off. And will reveal for again what seems to be adjustment screws. Maybe they will allow to adjust the center of this eyepiece correctly or something like this. Very shiny stuff you can see. At least if I scrap this unit, I will retrieve interesting hardware, which is always good. I will try to. Okay. And now the big reveal, what do we have behind this cover? When I scroll the top, it is actually the battery screw that will act like a cover retaining screw here. We could have used two more screws here. So on this side, we can expect to find maybe that is the issue here. Not sure. Okay. Big circuit board. Very serious die-cast construction here with a seal all around. You can see, slotted screws, and we have, okay, yes, definitely 92 dead codes on here. We have a lot of stuff, but should be quite delicate, actually, to access, mainly because of this flat cables. So probably here the main processor with a nice Topcon sticker on it. A lot of adjustment on the test points here must be related to the rotary encoders and all what we have in this unit, because if you do not know, if you do not see the other total station teardown, this unit contains a laser telemeter. It will be very nice to look at. So first, let me try to figure out what I can do. So here, obviously, we have the rotary encoder disk for this axis. And if I can, oh, again, if you remember the other total station teardown, we had problems with loose connections inside, very loose flat flex connections. And again here, same thing, really not impressive. They are coming very easily. Okay, I can see obviously here interesting stuff. But first, I need to be able to undo this board and flip it on the side. So it should be good like this. We have apparently six brass screws here. So let me undo the screws. So Fairchild brand, Fairchild Philips. All possible flavors of ICs in here. A lot of little trimmers. I can see two crystal oscillators. So what do we have? Two set screws here, probably very important for something. So now I can flip this part away. Here is the other side. Look at this. We have one LED that is shining on the thing here. One power voltage regulator, probably LM2940. Okay, a few passive parts, very old school PCB routing and very very fine tracks. So in here, first we can see a little bit better the probably a circuit board for this rotary encoder. There is a through-hole IC behind here. Will you see it? Just behind this flat cable here. That they did mount as a surface mount. The legs are bent at the end and it is surface mount through-hole. Interesting. So here I can see two cables going here, so it is probably a LED cleaning here through this glass disc, which obviously will not be possible to access unless I take apart everything, which I do not want to do for now. And here we have probably the readout sensors, but we have the same thing here apparently. So I am not sure what are. Maybe actually the LED we have here on the circuit board. So it is shining through the hole here and going to a sensor the other side, but it is not the main rotary encoder sensor. So maybe it will allow the device to know when the main optical part here is horizontal or something like this. Maybe it is just a position sensor, because here I do not think I will be able to take them apart, but we can see two maybe LEDs or photodiodes with golden package and golden legs. And on the other side, there is obviously a circuit board with a number of trimmers, and here also. So there are the sensors for the rotary encoder, and this thing is not coming apart easily because it is glued. But you can see at least the main glass disc with the rotary encoder, and there is here, these black lines are actually two rows of super fine stripes that will allow the device to figure out the movement and exact position. And also, what did I see here? Look at this. More fungus. Quite light deposition here, but they are existing. Piezoelectric speaker here. You can see the body of a Plumet eyepiece here. And it is all what we can see for this side of the device. So I will reinstall everything and we'll go to the other side. So this side now. Obviously, we have a keyboard on the cover. Just a regular PCB with contacts for the rubber keys. And one more PCB, probably more power management here. We have relays to activate stuff. Power resistor, coils, okay. We have this, which seems to be some kind of sensor. I will try to take it apart. And we have a better look here at the circuit board for the readout of the rotary encoder. So I will first undo completely this PCB to see what we have behind. So this sensor unit seems to be interesting, but there is a wire going here somewhere at the back. I am not sure if I will be able to open it and show you the contents. No, because it seems to be coated with silicone or something. So if I happen to scrap the unit, I will do a follow-up video where I will crack open this thing, but for now I believe it must be just a bubble level with optical readout, or maybe something with mercury or something like this. I do not want to spill mercury on my bench, by the way. So I will undo this part. This screw is loose. Oops. Very interesting. construction. So what do we have? Excuse me, I will retrieve a screw. So just apparently the wires going to the middle unit. You did see on the other side we have no nothing going in it. So here we'll just have again four wires with four rotary contacts. So probably again some serial communication with just power supply. Here we have the same mechanism we have on the other axis to secure the thing and allow a fine adjustment. And this box is really just a chrome color box with mounted on the bracket. Actually, I did try to undo it previously and there is nothing to see, it is potted. So it will require destructive teardown if I want to look inside this, but we have an interesting... So this model number, it is not necessary to Google it, you will find nothing. We have apparently a serial number and maybe a configuration number or calibration. Serial number here, so two parameters, one serial number. So probably a quite fancy unit to some sensor, for level sensor or something, but it is sadly quite potted together. And here just the rotary contacts, the battery wire here, nice more adjustments here, very nice hardware, this board. Yes, mostly power supply related, it seems. Capacitors, relays. Okay, so it was quite quick for this side of the device. Now we will go to the main piece of interest, the laser telemeter. Before I open the two main covers here, a quick look here, because we have again the same ring you can undo here with four adjustment screws. And we have this cover where you can see we have the main damage here. Some pretty bad impact did already leave a mark here. And also here. So this thing was maybe dropped or did flip over from his tripod during a job and was broken. Here also damage. Okay, it will go off completely. Ah, look at this nice prism assembly here. More or less like the ones you would find in binoculars, but smaller. And here the main optical. Well, I do not know what to expect for the next part of the teardown, so I will leave it unassembled for now, in case I need to undo this. There is here some, yes, focus adjustment, obviously. Okay, now, how to proceed. I have to undo these eight little screws to undo both of the covers. So let's start with it. So these ones are very tiny. My screwdriver is even too big for them. And it will reveal the contents of it. Might be a little bit difficult to show on camera, I will find out. So really, I am happy I did find this device, because they are still hard to find at decent prices in a broken condition for parts. Sometimes they are still very expensive, even broken. In particular, if you go with Nikon or Leica brands, or Sokia seems also an interesting brand to check out for these devices. So I keep an eye on eBay, and if I find on other ones, I will, at decent price, I will pick them up. But okay, we have here a nice cover. Ah, there is a little bit of damage I saw on this cover, actually. I did not notice it previously. We have some kind of viewfinder here. And it was pressed in, apparently. There is no damage here. There is an access hole here. Going to what? Maybe the, yes, either the trimmer here or the test point here. It was like this. Yes, it is to access this particular test point. Okay, you can see we have on this side one circuit board with small screws mounted onto this metal box shielding. There is obviously a big interconnection here, going to whatever we have next. And on the other side, aha! Apparently some power supply thing with what seems to be optical fiber. So the laser devices might be on this side. We will start to by undoing this side here. So how to proceed? Maybe it is not necessary to undo the wall. I will try to. Okay. No choice, because in fact I cannot reach one of the screws here. So I must undo the four little screws. So if you remember the teardown of the other total station, we had a very interesting stuff going on. And I expect it will be the same here. Probably even quite similar. Okay. All the screws going everywhere. So we have obviously one more fiber optic here, more electronics in this box. So maybe it is here the receiver side for the telemeter. There is this wood assembly, but you can see here little thing with three wires. So maybe it is some kind of three phase motor for rotary shutter or something like this, but I do not see at all how to remove this part. It is part of the wall unit here, and apparently not easy to undo. But maybe, at least, I can disconnect this optical fiber by undoing the two screws. Will it come off? I have no idea. Yes. Okay. Yes, it is a hand piece for optical fiber going in the optic here. So at least it will allow me to open this box in particular easily. And have a look at what we have in here. Then I will be able to reinstall everything and go to the other side. It is just in order to allow me easy reassembly and not ending with a pile of parts where I do not know where to reinstall them. Okay. Ah. Okay, so this did unconnect. Stainless steel shielding here. And we have here one interesting PCB with cristal oscillator. Super interesting piece here with ceramic board hybrid, 1/4 oscillator with golden legs, some ICs, and the optical fiber going in this unit. Which seems to be screwed by one screw here up. Is it possible to undo this cover now? Maybe not. I need to undo more screws, sadly. And now, okay, I see. We have two welds, so I need to unsolder this. I will be right back. Okay, I did undo the two solder points, so this piece of optical fiber is obviously screwed here with a special connector, and you can see we have apparently 4 set screws that will allow a precise center alignment of the optical fiber piece. And here we have simply what seems to be, so either it is the laser diode, either it is the receiver. Seems we have just 2 legs in this thing. Yes, so it is the receiving photodiode, but mounted on a serious piece of metal. Here you can see, so precisely aligned and timed stuff, and precise measurement. Of course, you are measuring the return speed of light wave, so it means it needs to be quite fast electronics. Interesting. Okay. So I will reassemble this side of the unit because obviously here there is nothing else we can take apart easily without stripping the whole optical unit, which seems to be super tedious. So we reassemble this and we will check the other side, which is probably the laser transmitter. Okay, it is back together on this side. And I was thinking to something, the 4 wires here are probably going to the rotary contacts. So this board must be some communication board that will communicate with the other processor board with a particular protocol through serial communication. So this thing has all the protocol, and they will talk together with just 2 wires apparently, plus power supply for the whole thing. Interesting. So on this side, apparently we have here one more optical fiber, but this time the connector is different, like this, and I am able to disconnect it easily. We have this time 3 screws that should allow me to undo the whole thing. Maybe we will see a little bit more of what is happening in the device. Okay. Connector or not connector? Rien de plus. Seems not. Okay, quite annoying. Here we have at least a setup we can take apart. So there is obviously some counterweight going action going on here with 4 what seems to be brass plates. Oops. Okay, it will reveal nothing interesting, but it was worth to check anyways. And I did just lose a screw, but I will fix it later. So we have this unit, at least, which seems to be standalone. I do not know because I do not see electrical connection to it. And the screw is perfectly stripped. Let me try another screwdriver. Okay. So here maybe we will be able to find something interesting if it comes off. Okay, is it coming off? Not easy to tell. Not easy to tell. It is pretty much stuck in here. I am not sure why. I can see nice stuff. There is some kind, yes. I will try to show you anyways. There is some kind of rotary shutter here. Yes, I can see a glass disc with black marks. So it will rotate with this super tiny motor and do some shuttering action. So probably there is a flat flex here connected here, and this is why I cannot pull it any further. It must be connected to a similar piece on the other side. Same setup here for the optical fiber, by the way. Interesting, but I cannot do anything else with it because it is stuck in place. And you can see, probably by removing the screws here, I did totally ruin the alignment because you can see the holes are long holes, so it will allow a little bit of adjustment. Super precise factory adjustment, which is now perfectly ruined. It is not a big deal because I am not going to use this device anytime soon. But oops, and one more fish to screw out, to fish out. Excuse me, one more screw to fish out. Okay, now we have just this piece left. I will reinstall this one if you let me do it, because really it is annoying. If I can. Okay, not necessary to get it tight. So we are left with this unit, which must contain most probably a laser diode. So let me undo again four little screws. Hopefully the PCB will come off easily. And this time I will not need to unsolder things. Maybe it should disconnect. Okay. And I still need to unsolder things. Okay. So here is what the circuit board looks like. But if you want, I want to go really in the detail here and see what we have in here. One more time. Some solder to remove. So the soldering iron is heating up again. I will just undo this in the meantime. Yes, apparently I do not know why, but here they did not use the connectors. The connectors are on the other side, but it is a little bit annoying. And you can see whatever we have here, it is secured by 4 screws. So give me a few seconds to undo these 2 solder points. Okay, I'm back. Oops. Of course, it was not 2 but 3 solder joints to undo here. Spare no expense. Okay, so what do we have? Yes, exactly as expected. What seems to be a tiny, actually, laser diode from neck, it seems, mounted between these 2 metal parts. 3 legs. Yes, AK. Yes, it is a laser diode. Tiny package. Interesting. Seems it has maybe its own serial number. So, pretty fancy stuff. You will notice the test points here are actually gold plated. So yes, it is a transmitter side. So the idea, you will transmit a pulse of light. It will be reflected on a mirror target. It will come back and it will calculate the delay and allow to know the distance. This combined to angle measurements, you can do a lot of things. Calculate areas of a land, piece of land, of a building, and everything. Even volumes, if you put the device on the roof of a building or something like this. So really, really powerful things for surveying. But it is a world art by itself, surveying, and I have no much more knowledge about this. Okay. So I believe it is all for this teardown, considering this will not come off. And the main optical piece seems quite stuck in here. I'm not sure how I would be able to extract it. But it was quite interesting. Anyways, this thing. So I believe most total stations would be built the same way. Except the most more modern ones are robotized and will move by themselves, which is not the case here. So I would love to find a more modern one with a robot action going on, but they are still super expensive. They are 5 digits price usually, something like 20,000 euros new, or 30 or even more. So use one, not under 2,000 euros for now. So I am searching, and I hope one day I will have a modern Leica one or something like this for cheap. Should be nice, but you never know what can happen. So maybe, maybe. Okay. I will put this back together for now, before I figure out what to do with it. If I happen to do a complete strip down, maybe I will do another video where I take it completely apart in fast motion. And then you will see the contents of a fancy sensor inside. And more details about the rotary encoders probably. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.